Hi, I'm another edition of Happy Rich TV, and guess who I'm with? The head of Sports TV 5, who happens to be the wife of Vin Ciso and one of my idols from Ginebra, yung pinakagwapo sa Ginebra yes! team nung Jaworski days. Grabe.
That's
you know what?
Happens.
I used to take sports clippings whenever the Ginebra
You're
would be.
You're one of those?
Yes, I'm one of those fanatics,
alam mo,
man.
Alam mo, natutuwa ako because Vince has multiple volumes yung kanyang kakapal na mga sports clippings. Kasi mas madami pang mga sports clips.
Oh, Anyeho Ram, ganyan.
Yes, diba, Gordon's, tapos Gors pa sila. So, ang dami-dami niyang sports clipping. So, natutuwa ako every time.
Iba kasi talaga yung Ginebra Days eh. Ewan ko, Gilas talaga yung closest talaga so far.
Actually, now, it's really a national phenomenon talking about Ginebra and Gilas. And really, the Ginebra then was, I guess, fed by that Jaworski.
Never say die eh. Parang, actually, if there's a theatrical version of basketball, it was during the Ginebra days.
Noong 90s.
People either hate Ginebra or they love Ginebra.
Exactly. But of course, I'm not gonna belittle the Ginebra of this generation kasi grabe talaga yung talent.
Mabawi naman. Okay naman yung new coach, diba?
Oo,
yung
handle
niya. Nag-good champion
it,
na ulit.
I have to give it to the fans of Ginebra, but of the PBA, iba talaga yung passion niyo. Saludo ako sa inyo. I love PBA fans.
So she's a sportscaster for 17 years.
Yes.
Wow.
Actually, noong 2 pa lang.
Si Diane Castillejo, medyo chummy na rin kami.
Yeah, I love Diane.
So, anyway, first question.
Hindi pa tayo sa first question.
Wala pa. Actually, introduction pa lang. So, yung first question ko pala is about your love story pala with Vince. I'm sure na-share mo somewhere. Saan mo ba na-meet si, ano?
We actually met through a friend. And ironically, we met at a wine bar where his friend who was playing for a band, Indio I, was there. And I happened to be there. Pero nung nang-meet kami, yung conversation namin was about the foundation. He has the Vince Ciso Foundation, and I have the Everyday's Your Birthday Foundation.
Daming foundation. So, now, you work for Maynila as well, diba?
That's further down the road. So, ganun kami nag-meet. It was really about the foundations.
Wow. So, advocacies pa yung pagpinag-meetingan niyo. At akala ko naman dahil kinover mo yung basketball game or something.
Hindi ka umabot.
Umabot ka ba doon?
Hindi.
So marami yung umiyak nung nalaman na ikaw na ang chosen one.
Eh, nakita mo naman kung paano nag-propose sa akin ang asawa ko, diba? Sa court. Half-time of a game in Araneta.
Sinong kalaban
niya? Live on TV. It was a Ginebra game but he was playing for Red Bull at that time. So,
ganun.
So it was a Ginebra game and it was nice because...
It wasn't yet in Team Ginebra yet?
No, tapos
after
na siya.
Na yung
tapos
season
na siya. 90s yung Ginebra. At 2003 siya nag-propose sa akin. June 8, 2003.
Wow. Ganda ng
so
love
fast
story.
Fast forward na yun.
And you were both Christians na at that time ba?
No,
or
actually.
Or when did you meet God? That Jesus pala?
Actually, no. It was during our marriage. And we share this in our testimony. Actually, we've been married for 14 years. But halfway through our marriage, or even before that, we met the Lord. But prior to that, that's really where our story started. You know, everyone thinks na, you know, what a romantic way to get proposed to. What a beautiful marriage that they had. But we also had our own problems. We had a lot of disagreements. And because we felt that we were so perfect for each other, we didn't know how to deal with problems. Hindi kami marunong mag-away.
Yun ang problema to, pag walang away.
Yes.
Pag nag-away, grabe na.
Oo nga, so yun.
Rambulan na.
So away kami. And we were actually at the verge of separation.
Oh my God.
So, and then,
dark moment yan.
Yes, very dark moment in our marriage. And then, Vince's cousin, who was already from CCF, invited us to go to a marriage outing for CCF in Baguio.
Wow, Baguio pa.
And so we decided to go, even though we were on the rocks already, and we kind of agreed that we were gonna start separating, though our kids were very
this
young.
Is your first Christian seminar
yes,
together?
Yes, that was our first time. And
so
we
before
went
this,
there.
You were in the other thing, the bigger thing, right? The one where everyone is born into, usually. I won't name it.
No.
Basta, no, yung the usual tradition stuff, right?
Yes, okay, yes. Okay. You know, we were churchgoers, but we didn't really have a relationship with the Lord, and it was only then that we both broke down and realized and understood how wrong we were by relying on each other for happiness when we should have just relied on the Lord for our personal
Amen.
Happiness. And that is what makes the marriage
work. Ang hiningi ko siyang advice, like some people I meet, they're so dependent on their boyfriend.
Yes, parang, and humans will always, you know, people will always disappoint you, but the Lord never will.
As controlling pa yung boyfriend nila, bawal ganyan, di ba? As bawal maglumabas, mag-music, whatever.
Ako yung controlling.
Ikaw na may controlling dito. Bawal, no, Vince, guwapo ka kasi delikado.
No, but right now we allow the Holy Spirit to control us. So now, we're far from perfect, but you know, we are very intentional with each other. We really base our relationship on the Bible and how we enjoy